I'm from a little town called Hardin, Kentucky. That's in Marshall County. Growing up in rural Kentucky was just like it sounds, traditional, being rural. My father, he was the worker. He was a car dealer. My mother was a stay-at-home mother. And so they raised the three of us. There were three daughters, and I was the youngest. And we were given the opportunity to go to school, to college. And so we were a first generation to go to college. My first nursing job was at Murray Calloway County Hospital as a labor and delivery nurse. I fell in love with labor and delivery because there was always this challenge of helping this person have the most wonderful experience in their life. That whole idea of being there, helping women do better with their lives, was intriguing to me from the start. We would have women come in that had been beat up or had been downtrodden, victimized, various things. Especially in a rural community like that, you see a lot of things. And to me, I could relate to them. There had been times in my life when I didn't have as much control as I had hoped to have, or I didn't get to choose, or I didn't feel like I had as much power over my life as I wanted to. So I felt empowered to help women from the very beginning, just from my own experiences. I always wanted to be a physician, but I was never encouraged to do that because I was a woman. But the dream was always there. I'd have pediatricians and OB docs that would sit me down and say, "Why are you going to nurse practitioner school? I know you want to be an OB-GYN. Go to medical school." And it was always, "No, my kids are in school. I can't move." Or, "I don't have the money for that, but I have the money for nurse practitioner school." To me, every stop of education is an ongoing learning experience. And so I think maybe as a young child, I knew this, that I never wanted to stop learning. So here I am now at Texas A&M in medical school. Coming from a nursing background, I've been at the bedside as a labor and delivery nurse. I've worked in the nursery with newborns. I've helped take care of postpartum patients at the bedside. I've taken care of women's surgical post-op. So for me, the next step as a physician is actually being the team leader. It's making those decisions. It's helping that woman decide what she wants to do with herself. It's being in the clinic and hearing the stories and being the provider who's actually there to see through the whole thing. Somebody might say, "You really love school." Well, yeah, I really love school. But I love learning and knowing more, being a lifelong learner. And as a physician, I will continue to learn.